Guys, welcome to my another tutorial, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can animate a watch like this. And as you can see, it ticks constantly and all the needles move related to each other, so you can just change one value and it will all work at once. So in order to do that, I can go to the outliner and deselect everything and hit Ctrl G to create an empty group. So I'm just going to rename it to Time Control. And if you go to the channel box and click Edit button, and you can add a new attribute. And if you click on that, you're going to see this. And you can just call your attribute whatever you want and make sure it's keyable and float. You can set minimum and maximum value. You can go with some big numbers like this. And if you're done, hit OK. Now you can see new attribute and it can be changed. So let's go to the watch model and make sure all your needles have their pivots in the center of the watch base, so it should rotate like this. So if I rotate, it's going negative, so I should put negative in front of every expression. It might be different in your case. So if you create a new expression in rotate Y of this object, you're gonna see this window, and you can just copy this attribute and type this is seconds, so it should rotate 6 degrees every second. So I can just do that, type negative 6 times time control dot time. Time control dot time will increase every second by one. So I can just type it in, and we're gonna deal with this time control later on. So I can just hit create. Now this attribute turned purple, that means it's working. And now move on to the hour hand. I can create new expression again, copy and paste, and hour hand should move 0.0083 degrees every second, so I can just copy and paste that. And times again, time control dot time, and put semicolon and hit create. Finally, the minute needle, you can just copy and paste again. And this time is should be 0.1, I believe. Again, time control dot time, create. And now let's go to the time control. Let's see how it's working. You can just increase this value. It seems to be working. I forgot to put negative there, should be hour. So 3 minutes. So I can type in negative mark there, and it should be all fine. Alright, now it's time to set the time control time attribute, and you're not going to see time in the attribute either, but you can just create new expression in any attribute, and you can just select time in the expression editor. So I'm just going to copy this attribute and paste it here, and I'm going to say is equal to frame divide by 24. If I create that, it moves like this. And it is like sweeping, but you may want to make this more snappy. So there's a way to do it. You can edit expression, and by the way, this is not the one actually. I'm just gonna again go to the expressionator and select time. By the way, this is your frame rate. If your frame rate is higher or lower, you should change this value to whatever frame rate yours is. And anyways, I can put an if statement and type in frame percentage mark, and for example, if you want to make this take every 1 second like quartz, but I want to make it more mechanical, so maybe I should type 3 equals 0, it will run. So it should be more snappy this time. Actually, 2 equal sign here, and hit edit. Now it's working. Again, if you want to make this snappy every 1 second like quartz, you can just type in 24, so it is more like quartz watch. And basically this is it. Now you can animate your watch. Actually, you can keyframe it manually, so if you want to speed this up, you can just simply go to time, and maybe you can just don't divide it. It will move a lot faster. Actually, you can delete this if statement if you want to take a lot faster than that. And again, if you want to start from a certain, you know, time, you can just type in some number and plus, just add it to that number. You can hit edit. So now we'll start from some other time. So this is it for this tutorial. So thanks for watching, and please subscribe and hit the like button if you like this video. Bye.